This is English video session for class 10. We are now learning the topic, chapter number 5, supplementary reader, footprints without feet. The name of the topic itself is footprints without feet. This is also the name of the textbook also is the same because of the importance it gives, the moral values it gives. That is why it is given like that. Okay. Yes. Now let's see what happened to the griffin. He is a scientist. Okay, he goes into the theater, the center of the theater world, okay, theoretical company. There, the for the drama, they keep all the mask, they keep shoulder, the face, nose, artificial nose, then they will have everything they will keep. So he steals all these things, and in order to escape from there, he carelessly attacks the shopkeeper from behind and he robs all the money that is kept in the box. Okay, now let's see what happens later. Eager to get away from the crowded London, he took a train to the village of Iping. So, from city, he has to move to some other place where people will not know about him, where he booked two rooms in a local inn. What is a local inn? Local hotel. Okay. So, hotel, usually winter, nobody goes because it's a time when people want to retire. They don't go in for long tours. Okay. Unlike summer. The arrival of the stranger at the inn in winter was an unusual event. So nobody comes during the winter time because people cannot travel, first is that, and people love to be inside the doors. They don't go in for long tours. A stranger of such uncommon appearance sit all tongues wagging. So who is this? The entire body is the sheep, the his body shape, everything looked unfamiliar, and everybody was wondering who this individual was. A stranger of such uncommon appearance set all tongues wagging. Wagging means what? Oh, what is this? What is this? Who is this? Who is this? Why did he come in this winter? Who is this? Unusual. So all these things are called wagging. Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, made every effort to be friendly. So Mrs. Hall is who? The landlord's, the inn owner, the hotel owner's wife. Okay, Mrs. Hall. She is trying to become friendly. Do you want that? Do you want this? She is inquiring. She is trying to help him out so that he will become friendly. But no, Griffin doesn't allow himself to be friendly. But Griffin had no desire to talk to her and told her, "My reasons for coming to Epping is a desire to talk, is a desire to be solitude." What is solitude? To be alone. Okay, to be alone. "I do not wish to be disturbed in my work. Besides, an accident has affected my face. An accident has affected my face." Okay. "I do not wish to disturb in my work. Besides, an accident has affected my face." Okay, he tells it has affected my face. Satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist, and in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance, Mrs. Hall was prepared did not last long. Mrs. Hall was prepared to excuse his strange habits and irritable temper. Nobody will be coming during the time of winter. And somebody has come and he is asking her not to disturb. Griffin says, "Okay, no problem. Anyhow, I am getting money." So she never opened her mouth. Okay. "My reasons for coming to Epping," he told, "is for solitude." Solitude means loneliness. "I don't want anyone to disturb. I want to be lonely. Okay. I don't want to be disturbed. I am going to work. Okay. Due to some accident, my face is affected. So my face is affected because of, say, so I should not be exposed to the sunlight. I will not be coming to the sunlight. My face accident may face is a hoge." Satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist. Was an eccentric scientist something different? He was not unusual and he is quite strange. And the view that the fact that he was paid her advances mean the amount that is required to be paid for the two rooms of the inn. He pays in advance. So she did not mind the strange and the irritable temper. But the stolen money did not last long, and presently Griffin had to admit that he had no more cash ready. So after, how long will that money which he stole will be there? He is spending heavily, so he did not have much money in his hand. He pretended, however, he was expecting a check to arrive at any moment. So he pretended the money is expected to come soon. Once the money comes, I will give you the remaining amount. Shortly after, a curious episode occurs. Very early in the morning, a clergyman and his wife were awakened by the noises in the study. Creeping downstairs, they remarked that a chink of money has been taken from the clergyman's desk. Without making any noise, with the poker grasped firmly in his hand, the clergyman flung to open the door. Surrender. Okay, so look at what has happened. There's a clergyman, he goes, so now he wants money, so he goes to steal money. Where did he go? He goes to a clergyman, one who works in the church. Okay, now what does he do? He goes and clinging, everybody, the people could able to hear the, he creeps down and he tries to take all the money from them. He takes the money, but the coin sound is heard and the clergyman and his wife comes out, but they did not find anybody. They did not. And the clergyman shouted, surrender. Okay, now let's see what happened. Clergy is the one who works in the church, churchman. Then to his amazement, he realized that the room was appeared to be empty, but there was no one in the room. Are this is something amazing. He and his wife looked under the desk and behind the curtains and even up the chimney. There wasn't sign. So as they escaped through the window, chimney, no sign of anybody. Yet the desk has been kept open and the housekeeping money was missing. But the money is missing. Nobody is seen. Extraordinary thing, the clergy said, saying that the rest of the day. So how could it be possible? But it was not as extraordinary as the behavior of Mrs. Hall's furniture a little later. That morning, same thing happened to Mrs. Hall. The landlord and his wife were up very early and were surprised to see the scientist's door wide open. So the scientist's door was wide open. The opportunity seemed too good to be missed. So now they have, the door is open, so they peeped in. What is peeped in? They are entering inside. Okay, the door. So nobody and decided to investigate. Now let me see what is going on inside. The bed clothes were cold, showing that the scientist must have been up for some time. So maybe the clothes were all there, the bed clothes were cold, showing that the scientist must have been up for some time. The stranger still cold, the clothes and the bandages, and he was wearing all that he wore about, everything lying, the bandages which he used to cover his face, everything was lying in the floor. Okay, all of a sudden Mrs. Hall heard a sniff close to her ear. Sniff means what? Breathe. A moment later on the bedpost. Okay, the bedpost, and what happened was, a moment later the hat was on the bedpost and leaped up, the dashed in itself into her face. Then the bedroom chair became alive. Oh, nobody is there, it is moving up and down. Springing in the air, it charged straight on her legs for almost. Okay, she would have fallen on her. And she and her husband turned away in terror. The extraordinary chair pushed them both out of the room. So the chair itself pushed them outside the room and then appeared to slam and lock the door after them. After they went out, the door was locked. Everything happened, but there was nobody seen. So that was curious for both of them, Mrs. Hall and her husband. In whose room did it happen? Griffin's room. Mrs. Hall almost fell down in the stairs in hysteries. Hysteries means what? Shouting out of fear, wailing, shouting and like a mental person, hysterically, because she was so very afraid of what has happened. Okay, hysterics, and she convinced that the room was haunted by spirits, and she took it that it is haunted by spirits. Spirits? Ghost. Okay, ghost. And that the stranger had somehow caused these into her furniture. So inside these furnitures, the ghost has entered and they are moving. So what did the griffin, that fellow who had come, he has only made ghost, spirits, and they have entered into my furnitures, and the furnitures are moving and they are pushing. This is what she said. Clear? My poor mother used to sit in that chair. So she moaned. Why? She is crying. To think it will rise up against me now. Look. This chair is now raising against to kill me. So she was not able to understand what has happened. She was crying. Okay. Now, children, so far what we have done, it's so some of the things which the griffin, as after becoming invisible, he is homeless, moneyless, clothless, and above all, invisible. But he because of the winter, cold winter, he is not able to bear it, and he starts stealing money. And he requires a place to stay. He goes to Epping Inn. But there he terrorizes Mrs. Hall and takes away the money from the clergy's family house. Okay, children. Now, remaining part, what all we have done also, you read it. And also, what we have planning, what is yet to be done also, please read and come. I may be asking some questions. Okay. Please be ready, children. This is part of your PT2, so you have to prepare well. Okay, children. Thank you.